الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته dear brothers and sisters first of all I would like to say Ramadan Mubarak to all of you and welcome for this simple tazkirah I think many of you already or all of you already know what to do in this Ramadan right but just I would like to emphasize several things need to seriously be taken into consideration that is in regard to the sahur. Many people they are so neglecting or when we say not take the sahur a serious matter in Ramadan. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam have said in one of the hadiths that the difference between the fasting of Muslims and the Jew and also the Christian depend on the sahur. The meaning is that in Islam, the sahur is very important practice of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam compared to the other religion, particularly the Jew and the Christian. They also fasting, but normally they are not practicing the sahur. So sahur is very important for us to follow the sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And because there are many benefits in this sahur, because don't take sahur. So for example, many students was in this campus or also in the public, they are not really doing their sahur. Maybe because they are lazy to wake up at early morning, let's say about half an hour or 20 minutes before the azan of subuh, they need to do their sahur. But because sometimes they sleep late, you know, 3 o'clock, or sometimes even 4 o'clock they sleep, then they are very difficult for them to wake up before Fajr. So that's why they're neglecting this sahur. Or sometimes they take the sahur as early as possible, which means after midnight before they go to sleep, they already take the sahur, which is not encouraged. That kind of practice is not encouraged at all in Islam. So when we do the sahur and then after that, we are getting ready to get the subuh prayer, Fajr prayer, you know, in jama'ah and so on. So that's why it is not proper for us to take sahur as early as possible, or maybe after the tarawih, and then we sleep and we wake up after the fajr. It is not good. It is not good. Only it is not the practice of the true faithful, true Muslim. So the true Muslim, they must observe this sahur. And similarly, another important thing is that about the iftar. About the iftar also, if we can take, if the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam encouraged us to take the sahur as late as possible, which means closer to this subuh prayer. But in regard to the iftar, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam encouraged us to break fast as soon as possible, or as early as possible after the azan for the that is not delaying our iftar and not do the sahur as early as possible. So we are in, if we want to follow the sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, then that is the guideline the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave us to breakfast as early as possible, to do the sahur as late as possible. So I think in this brief session, so I would like to advise all my brothers and sisters all over the world, Malaysia, so do your sahur and practice this iftar according to the sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So that's the thing I could advise this small tazkirah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.